everybody doing?
Good evening, Sweden. That was weird. You guys were listening to the record. We were right over there.
We're right back there doing interviews. Very interesting.
We were like this, boo? No, I think they like it. It
wasn't us.
So this is going to be a very intimate, very kind of impromptu session for us. We even only brought one tuner, so we're going to pass it. So if you guys come to our shows, you know I tour with like 13 guitars. I use a different guitar almost on every song. It's kind of part of the show. Tonight I'll be using one.
But it has 12 strings.
Okay.
All right.
What do you like? You ready? One, two.
I'm gonna know, river. very good. Woo!
Hey, Darren, I know we may have one or two set lists in the back, but I don't think we have one up here.
We don't know who we're going to We're going to have to do a little bit of tuning while we're up here to talk to you.
We're going
to
have to.
I once saw a Neil Young show, and he tuned out loud, and he would just tune out loud for 10 minutes. And after, like, you know, several times of doing this, because he tunes on the old school, like, Peterson strobe tuner, he just came out and went... He just got on the mic and said, "It's gonna be better in tune. So just be patient. Please don't worry. You'll like it better once I'm in tune." So that's what I'm saying.
Well, it's good to be back here. We just flew in last night, and I'd say we're a little bit jet lagged, but we've been answering questions. This is a press trip for us. So we're just holding interviews all day long. It's been very interesting. Suffering through that, I think I've had 8 espressos today.
That's scary. Almost as scary as my 1 coffee after waking up at 4 in the morning. I don't know, it's worse.
All right, let's do a... Okay. This is from the Feral Roots album.
This one's a naughty but a goodie.
If you see that stranger coming in the air, and if you don't recognize him, I know you're pretty well. And got a voice like sugar shining in your teeth. It could sing you in a song now. Sing it sweeter than me. Blind your eyes, steal your tongue. They'll take it when you're old, but it locks on you. Oh my baby, devil's gonna get you if I don't feel. See that stranger is coming. Thank you. You guys hear everything okay out there?
Yeah.
You're great.
Oh, thanks. You're great, too. I love you back. That's very nice of you to say.
Jordan!
So with, I hope you guys like the record, you know.
We love it.
That's good to hear. It's,
we made it for ourselves, but we really hope you guys would like it.
It's very strange. We worked on this record for a couple of years under, we worked on the record for a couple of years under very strange circumstances. You know, the whole world kind of had to lose its mind for a little bit. And, so during that shutdown, so now this was a very unique experience for us to be back there, knowing that you're all out here listening to that record. Really wild. We also got to see the vinyl physically for the first time today. And that's really wild because we worked on this record for such a long time. So to know that it's actually going out, to know that it's actually leaving us and going out to be out there is really trippy. Yeah.
Shh.
Strings, six strings, and eight strings. So anyways, working on this album as long as we did, and then doing all of these interviews and actually talking about the process, it's a little bit emotionally disorienting. And the only reason for that is when you start talking about something that you had to grow, and you had to, we had to collaborate. We worked so hard on this record, actually on this collection of two records. Well, to put it into words and to look at it retroactively and try to make sense and answer personal philosophical questions about what your goals were and all of these different things, it's really apparent to me, and Scott and I talk about it, that it's important not to rewrite your own history when you're discussing what that process was like, you know, and not romanticizing or making it sound more masterminded than it actually was. I think it was really us just working as hard as we could to push our own boundaries with what type of music we wanted to be creating in the future. And to write about things, for me, writing all the lyrics and everything, writing about things that were important to me, writing about things that I wouldn't mind talking about every night, you know. And so, yeah. Nice. This is a. Woo!
Something fun and different for y'all, man.
What's that?
We're gonna try something fun and different.
We're gonna try something different. To sit along the wild way. You better go by now. It ain't no use to sit along the wild way. It'll never do you any. Where your rooster crows at the break of dawn, look out your window, I'll be gone. You're the reason I'm traveling. Don't think twice, it's all right. Well, ain't no turning on your light. That light I never knew. It ain't no use in turning on. I'm on the dark side of the moon. I wish there was something you could do, say. Try to make me change my mind and stay. We never did too much talking anyway. I don't think twice at all. Calling out my name, like you never done before. It ain't no use of calling out my name, I can't hear you anymore. Well, I'm thinking at a woman walking down the road. I won't slow the woman, child, I'm told. I gave her my heart, but she wanted my soul. Don't think twice, it's all. So long, babe, where I'm bound, I can't tell. Goodbye's too good a word, babe, so I'll just say fairly well. I ain't saying that you treated me unkind. You could have done better, but I don't mind. You just kind of wasted my precious time. Don't think twice, it's all right. We're still getting a little bit of feedback up here. I don't know if that's from the monitor or what's going on, but yeah, I remember my pop used to cover that song when I was a real little kid, and my sister and I used to make fun of him because we were terrible. We'd be like, "Pop, any song you sound like, it always sounds country." But by the time I was in like sixth grade, I was like, "Fuck, I love that song." Listening to like Free Will and Bob Dylan and all of that.
Jordan!
Do you sneeze? What was that? If anyone would like to ask Scott any questions, he's open for me.
What level of anxiety do you have from missing your pedal board?
Zero. Zero, yeah. The effects, which become known to everybody and everyone gets excited about it, it's a means to an end. You know, we've created these will be our eighth and ninth albums, so every record something new happens, there's new sounds. Every record I try to incorporate maybe at least three or four totally new sounds that you haven't heard. You guys just heard the new record. There's new stuff. There's new tones. It's reminiscent, but it's new and different, you know? So every time I do that, some new little robot has to jump on that board. So if you multiply three or four new things by nine albums.
How much, Ian?
58 pedals?
What's that?
58 pedals?
That's not what I have, so I'm doing pretty good. What were you going to ask?
How much gear do you carry on the tube?
I believe the answer's too much.
Me personally or the band? I take a lot of guitars, and I take a lot of robots.
The thing is, look, it comes down to this, is like, for Scott, I'll jump in and defend my brother here, but because you're going to pick him apart. It's the way that we write and the way that he plays, there are different tunings. And there are baritone guitars, and there are double neck guitars, and so there are all of these things. And sometimes a specific song will call for a specific guitar. Regardless of everything he has programmed into his pedal board and all of that, it takes a specific guitar. So we're always talking at the top of a tour, like, okay, well, what are we gonna do? Because we've only got so much room.
Here's the real answer. I take enough gear to get the motherfucking job done.
Yeah.
Good answer.
I'm feeling extreme feelings of jet lag right now. You guys are making me feel too darn warm and coming to just...
He's tuning up. I'll tell you guys this. You guys saw. You guys were watching the video for that one.
Yeah.
I think most people know, but when I was writing that video, the treatment for, very specifically, I wanted to cast Scott's son, Devendra. You know, and he's the kid that's on the bike, and we took the day to make that video, and we were outside and up in the Mojave Desert up there. And the lighting was perfect because it was high clouds everywhere, and so all of the light gets dispersed really evenly, and that makes it, you know, the film loves that sort of light and the landscape and all of that. But we worked out there from early morning until late at night. I'm sure we would have been arrested for child labor. But Devendra, he did such a great job just all day. We were like just throwing smoke bombs at him and everything. And he was a trooper, loved the whole thing. He really did a good job.
Jordan.
Is that a sneeze?
I love that song too, like, no shit. I love that song. When I'm singing that song, it's one of those things, like, I feel like I'm eating, like my mother's cooking or something. Like, there's something, like, just really comforting about that song, the melody and the message and all of that. You can go through a lot of bullshit in your life. You can lose yourself, and that's okay. You can lose yourself for a little bit, because finding yourself is extremely important. And sometimes you got to lose yourself first. But I love that song. I'm glad you do too.
Thank you.
I love to tune so much. It's part of why I got into this. Tune as much as possible. It's just the greatest thing. And nothing better than a crowd when you're tuning. That's when you're really doing it.
No stress.
Feel better.
Stress. Get that guy a tissue. He's got really sneezing a lot.
I got.
We'll see.
Feel better.
How you feel? You doing all right?
Okay. This is a pretty new thing to perform for us. So you guys are getting a pretty new look at a song that we really haven't.
First time in front of an audience, actually. Right?
There you go. Woo! Very nice.
Thank you.
November 18th at BK. Yeah. Hope to see you guys there. Woo! And we're back.
Is there a moderator for the Q&A? Darren,
are you going to moderate? Front row.